Okay. Hold on. Right. You ready?
Yeah.
Go for it. Let me see.
February 3rd.
Wait a minute. Am I recording? I think I am. Yeah. Go ahead.
All right. February 3rd. Have given up since January 10th. Day after essay meeting and last letter. 3 weeks stagnant. Lies about doctor, no meds, staying in room, connected to YouTube and Netflix for mental stimulation, prison of the mind, no desire to
do recording. Hold on, I gotta record this. Thanks. Wait. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, hold on. No, we're doing it, we're doing it. Go ahead.
Start with the one thing you know to be true about the spiritual realm. Reiki. I experienced it physically. Thomas Anderson, love and light. God, I hate myself. Dog. February 23rd. Almost done watching season 1 of Lost. One or two episodes left. Don't really care. Looked up Humane Society website again. Larry Buster Poe has been adopted. It made me think of Dr. Cushman and spirit animals. Mine was a puppy, he said. So I've Googled it and have been thinking about dogs and Copper and Buster, and it's hit a nerve. Been listening to explosions in the sky. Hit a nerve. Thinking about John still in jail. Still calling and writing letters. How scared he must be about getting out. How scared I would be. How scared I will be when the day comes where I have nowhere to go. Looked up that awful article again in the national scene. It's very hard to laugh about my past. She's a whore, yeah. She's a crazy bitch. Met her in a past life. Chris Proctor Merriweather, Ladybug Stomp. Made me think, Mom, I'd like to buy that album for her. Then, no computer and CDs. How do people even really listen to music these days? Or go about buying it for each other? Are CDs really so old-fashioned? For those with older, less fancy cars? Dear John, I'm really so very sorry for the way I've been, just ignoring all your calls and your letters. I read them all, and I really did just want you to stop writing, because after the last one I wrote you, I want to toss that out. It's a lot easier to communicate that you have nothing to say by just not saying anything at all. It reminds me of the riddle. If you say my name, I am no longer there. What am I? Give up? Silence. Okay, so what my silence has been trying to communicate is that I don't want a relationship with you anymore, again, at all. And that's the truth. And that is hurtful, bitchy, awful thing to say, so I figure silence is better. I know I've said I love you. I think I even wrote it. In my last letter, I said romantic stuff about a Van Morrison song, and God, I'm so embarrassed. Said I would write to you about my thoughts on marriage, because I know you've been holding the space in your mind of the possibility of us possibly being meant to be together and building a future. I hope the prolonged silence dashed that desire, or hope, or delusion, or whatever it was. I hope you are free of it without being angry or resentful of me or God. Okay, and this is hard to express. Hold on, I need to think. I'm listening to this awesome song, Tango, by Trace Bundy on an album called The Dap. It just came on Pandora. It's just a guitar instrumental. Good music for thinking. Oh God, it just changed to Use Somebody, a cover of Kings of Leon by Two Cellos. Check them out when you get out, Two Cellos. They do these gorgeous covers of songs with only, you guessed it, Two Cellos. I know you mentioned that song in your last letter. I love that song. Kings of Leon aren't my jam. Ha, I've never used that expression before. Did I fuck it up? Okay, wow, I just amused myself. That was surprising. Freedom of expression. Okay, forget that. Back to business. Where was I? Ugly or God? Something about my desire or hope or delusion, too. I really, honestly think you're an incredible person who's funny and smart and silly. And I was totally crushing on you as you shared yourself, even though you don't have a car or a job or, I guess, technically you're homeless. I'm sorry, John. I can't do this. I can't trust myself with honesty. That's the most honest thing I can say. I'm lost. Lost inside my mind. A Conversation with God, Part 1, YouTube. Experience being, knowing you do not reap what you do not sow. Why suffering, deep personal disappointment, and worldwide calamity. I do not demonstrate my love by not allowing you to demonstrate yours. I do not show my goodness by creating what you call perfection all around you. I gave up on that train of thought, obviously, trying to explain why I said I love you on the car. I remember it was true. I loved you and wanted to help you in the same way I loved all people and would have wanted to help anyone however I could. And I wrote it in a letter as more of like a friend, I think, and wanting to say it to you because you had said it in your letters. And yes, there was a time when I entertained thoughts and possibilities of you somehow being in us one day. And I would actually be out on my own and functioning in the world and living with joy and friends. But then I lost the faith in myself. The willingness to go to recovery meetings is not there anymore. I wasn't even going to send this. It would have just been another letter but got it abandoned. But I picked up my notebook to write some notes about this YouTube video. It's actually a book that I stumbled across online while Googling any phrases related to my miserable thoughts. I know, it's resonated with me. All I know is I'm wanting to go to Trader Joe's with my mom tomorrow to get some groceries. And it's the first time I've actually wanted to go anywhere in a long time. Since the essay meeting I went to and then wrote you, I gave up on outpatient meetings with God or myself or whatever soon after. Okay, anyways, I'm sorry. It's 2:30 in the morning. And all I really want you to know is that you're on my mind. And I know your court date is in a couple days. You may get out, so I'm not sure if you'll still even be in there to get this. Guess we'll see. I'm praying for you right now on this sudden burst of hope. Since listening to this book on YouTube seems to have restored a bit of willingness. Praying that God gives you the wisdom and discernment and opportunity to go where you need to go when you get out. I'm praying the right halfway house will present itself, that you'll find a job that you're happy with, and we'll keep that you won't go out looking for a random hookup just to get laid. You're too spiritually mature for that, friend. That you won't find yourself in some situation where... I don't know where I was going with that.
Well, I'll put it on YouTube for you.
I am so tired. I don't know what to do. I want to go to sleep, and I want to go find you. My movements are restricted. My choice is not my own. I'm starting to remember I'm reaping what I've sown. My brain feels so exhausted. My breathing feels so heavy. Like maybe a dam is broken and water's pouring down the levee. This is being a writer. I don't like it very much. I'd rather be a dancer or a lawyer and such. Now I'm waiting on authority to tell me what to do, and all I care about is only pleasing you.
I'll put this on YouTube for you, baby. Then maybe you'll find what it is. Let's see. Stop this.